Travis Bennett. I'm an H3 that got trained up at Wallaby Ranch with Aerotow, and I just concluded my second visit to Lookout Mountain Flight Park for the hill training and for the lift launch training. So as you can see, I have a support 3 sitting on top. Thank you, Will's Wing. You did an amazing job. And the car is driving itself, so to speak. It is level 2 automation, comparable to Tesla, but it is a Toyota. What I'm showing you now can be used with a long list of compatible cars that you can find on the website I'll give you near the end. It includes Toyotas, Hondas, Acuras, anything that has built-in safety features, advanced safety features like lane keeping assist and dynamic cruise control. And it converts those safety features into control features. It does so using a kit that costs less than $1,000 and some software that's mostly open source software. That kit includes some safety related hardware that plugs into the safety CAN bus located behind your rear view mirror, has code RUM on it. Includes a 10 centimeter precision GPS that isn't heavily used yet, but will be used in the future. With an adapter, a power supply cable for Toyotas at least, and a high powered cell phone with a heatsink and mount and fan. That is an interface to and from AI, artificial intelligence, that has 10 million miles driven behind its model. So why am I sharing this video? I'm sharing this video because I'm really hoping that other pilots can take advantage of it if their favorite flying site is far away, or if they're traveling a long distance for a comp or a match or a meet, or maybe you have to deliver a ton of gliders on a trailer across the country, Steve, and want your trip to just be a little less exhausting, more relaxing, less stressful. So I'll point the camera back at what you're really interested in. Anyway, again, it's compatible with a long list of cars that you can find on the website I'll give you at the end. But the software is called OpenPilot, and it's being spearheaded by a company named Comma. And yeah, the hang glider on top works well with a rack where the parts of the rack won't be confused with the lane lines. It's using a forward-facing camera that's part of the cell phone. It's using the vehicle's lane keeping assist camera. It's using the dynamic cruise control built into the vehicle, and then again it has a 10 centimeter resolution GPS that will be more used in the future, shortly down the road. The website is comma, comma.ai. So comma, just like the punctuation, .ai is the end of the website. I use this software package along my 30 to 40 minute commute to and from work on a road named River Road, so you can only imagine that that one has some curves to it. I also use it going back and forth to Lookout Mountain, and I'll use it to return to Wallaby soon. Also great for long road trips to see your family. So for the rack, to avoid being confused with lane lines, I used two absolutely vertical pieces of plumbing hardware, and I painted them black so that they wouldn't be confused with paint on the road, and would have less reflection to the cameras and less glare for me. No lines or cables that can be confused. blowing lines for this setup. And you still have to keep your attention out the window. You still have to maintain situational awareness. It helps with steering and gas and brake. It does not alleviate the need to be ready to take the wheel at any time, but it makes the drive a lot more relaxed. comma.comma.ai and open source project OpenPilot. It took me a couple of days to install because I chose a vehicle newer than the vehicles on that compatibility list and could take the time to try to make it work together. There's a long list of vehicles on that compatibility list where you could set it up and get it working over the course of maybe 3 or 4 hours. Once you get the hardware and install it in the car, go for a couple of test drives, and you're good to go. So I'll start a thread in the Oz Report forum. If y'all have any questions, feel free to ask. No guarantees I'll be able to answer, but I'll do the best I can. The Discord forum, the Discord chat rooms for this project are very responsive and very helpful as well. My username on there is ChaseCar, C-H-A-S-E-C-A-R. Know what you're thinking, and the answer is no, but if only it could follow you from the air while you're in the air and then pick you up. But no, it's not driverless. That would be level 5 or higher automation. This is level 2. get that hang glider that's a little farther away. Decide to change your vehicle. select a vehicle for this project, do your homework carefully. The forums are very good for the comma.ai website.
On the route. Stop and go traffic.
comma.ai is the website, and there's a community around the open source aspect of it called OpenPilot Community, opc.ai. So that's Oscar, Papa, Charlie, Dot, Alpha, India, and then comma, spelled out the word for the punctuation, comma, dot, Alpha, India, AI. Questions or want to talk about it, the best that I can answer.